10 semifinalists were selected today based on a technical evaluation of their submissions, as well as a programmatic assessment to ensure that the submissions are aligned with the goal and objectives of the National Action Plan for Combating Antibiotic-Resistant Bacteria. These 10 semifinalists, along with the other 64 individuals or groups that applied, are all eligible for step two of this competition, as is everyone else. In other words, individuals or teams that did not submit anything for step one are indeed eligible for submitting for step two. This particular competition is conducted under the American Competes Act, and as such, it allows both academic researchers as well as pharma, biotech companies, but also the general public to submit new and novel ideas. And so where normally someone applying for a grant to the NIH would most probably have an academic appointment and an established research facility, this particular competition allows individuals who are not our normal grantees or perhaps contractors to BARDA to submit ideas. So it is generally a very broad call for unique ideas and innovative approaches by individuals who perhaps are not involved in biomedical research, but in other disciplines and scientific fields. The majority of the semifinalists are focusing on either identifying one or more of the 18 drug-resistant pathogens that the CDC listed in 2013. There are a few of the semifinalists that are focusing on being able to differentiate between a bacterial infection and a viral infection. Both of these categories are indeed eligible for potential for this competition. NIH and BARDA are both involved in the development of both diagnostics as well as potential new antibiotics. This particular competition, by identifying new and better diagnostics, could indeed be used in clinical trials of new formulations and new compounds that could be used as antibiotics or other approaches. So diagnostics are very critical for the conduct of clinical studies.